He knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Okay, let's do some calculations involving pH and pKa. A 0.0516 molar solution of HNO2 has a pH of 2.34, and we want to know what is the Ka of this acid. So we're going to have to do some acid-base equilibrium calculations. This is a relatively weak acid, so it's not going to completely dissociate, so we're going to have to maybe do an Icebox here. So go ahead and check out my tutorial on this subject if you need to, and when you're ready, give it a shot. Okay, let's write out our acid-base equilibrium. We have nitrous acid reacting with water to yield hydronium and the nitrite ion. So that is the equilibrium we are dealing with. And let's go ahead and write out the Ka expression. Just like any other equilibrium, that is going to involve the concentrations of the products over the concentrations of the reactants. Now, we will first note that water is not present in that expression because it is a pure liquid. Remember, we only put aqueous species and gases in our equilibrium expressions. And we will also note that there are no exponents because these all have coefficients of 1. So it is a very simple Ka expression, and it will be important to use. So that is what that is. And now, as we said, we're going to need to set up an Icebox. So we've got our initial change in equilibrium, and then we have each of the aqueous species here. So let's start out by inputting our initial concentrations. These are the concentrations that were given. And so the only one that was given is 0.0516 for nitrous acid. So when we say that is the concentration of the acid, that is the moles per liter of acid that exist upon placing the acid in the solution. Once it is in solution, acid-base reactions will begin. But at the beginning, we have that many moles per liter of acid, and we have no hydronium or nitrite ion. So this is prior to any ionization. Then, immediately upon putting the acid in solution, acid-base reactions begin, which means some of the nitrous acid will react, it will deprotonate, and for every nitrous acid that deprotonates, we get one hydronium and one nitrite ion. So some of the reactant gets used up, so the change for that will be minus X, and then the change for the product will be plus X, because for every X that's used up for the reactant, we get X for the products. Let's also make sure to understand that these come from the stoichiometric coefficients. We have minus 1x and plus 1x and plus 1x because we have a 1-to-1-to-1 ratio for the stoichiometric coefficients from the balanced equation. If those had different coefficients, if we had two hydroniums in the balanced equation, we would have to have plus 2x in the change box for hydronium. But everything is 1-to-1-to-1, so those are going to be the change values. Then lastly, for the equilibrium values, we just take the initial and the change and add them together. So 0.0516 minus x, and then 0 plus x is simply x for the two products. So there is our completed Icebox. So what can we do with this? Well, we do have one other piece of information. We know that the pH of the solution is 2.34. Well, what is pH? pH is just a way of measuring hydronium concentration, specifically the hydronium concentration once equilibrium has been reached. And so we know that the hydronium concentration at equilibrium is 10 to the negative pH, or 10 to the negative 2.34. And so therefore we know that the hydronium concentration at equilibrium is 0.0046 molar. That is just expressing the same value that the pH is expressing, just in a different way. So we can put 0.0046 in for the equilibrium value for hydronium. That is what we know based on the pH. So we can put that in the table. Now we know that that was X, which means that 0.0046 equals X, and we can therefore put that in anywhere else we see X. That means the nitrite ion concentration is also 0.0046, And then we can get the nitrous acid concentration by taking 0.0516 minus 0.0046, which is 0.047. And now it will be very easy to calculate Ka. We take our Ka expression up there. We know it's going to be hydronium concentration times nitrite concentration over nitrous acid concentration. And that is 0.0046 times 0.0046 divided by 0.047. Those are the numbers we just got from the equilibrium row of our icebox. And we do the arithmetic, and the Ka value is 4.5 times 10 to the negative 4.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.